Holy shit. We are back. We're back. Just trying to find my way home. Let's turn off this shitty music. Ah, hello, my lovelies. Oh, son of a bitch. Sorry, they turned on the air conditioning here in my house, and, yes, so that's that. Welcome back. I'm glad to be back here, folks. This is WFWF Netwood. I've been gone for a while, actually. And that's because... That's because I've actually been working on a project of my own. You fans definitely know about it. I've talked about it numerous times. Endless, countless amounts of times. Jesus! Always the first! Always the first! Great to see you again. I know, right, PS3? Clamps! My brother. Black power in the house. happy Sunday, folks. I'm a little bit tired, but I'm not completely drained. I'll be doing that later. No, I'm kidding. Not really. I'm single. I'm alone. it is happening, CJ. It is back. We are back today. And, I haven't been around in a while, mainly because I've been working on my own game. I can only tell you the minimal details. I can tell you that it is something that fans deserve and fans should have gotten a long time ago. And, indeed, Clamps, indeed. Hello, Wanted. How are ya? It's good to be back, folks. Thanks. Thank you guys for joining. But yes, I am currently in the process of getting the ball rolling on my video game. And there's going to be some pretty good surprises to it. And I discussed with some of the developers and stuff like that to oversee all that goes on. So, indeed, Showstopper. Season 2, that's right, Clamps. PS3, I've been talking about it like on and off for the past couple of years, and so I got tired of waiting for my creative partner to get off his ass and do something. So I'm like, dude, we've had this idea for 10 fucking years. We need to start processing and producing some fucking material here. Well, whichever sounds closest to you, Clamps. I'm tired as shit. I did a show last night for Freak Show in Vegas, and then we came straight home right after. So that's about 8 hours altogether. That's a round trip in boiling hot-ass weather, constantly trying to stay hydrated, all that shit. So, let's see. But yes, my lovelies, I'm very excited to be working on this game for you guys. As I stated, I can only tell you the minimal amount of details because, well, I like surprises. I like surprising people. I like revealing, you know? So. Indeed, Clamps, it is a fucking great time. It's so much fun there at Freak Show Wrestling. And, yeah, I mean, anybody who attends a show always has a fantastic, phenomenal time. So, I forgot no fun. I do like exposing PS3. Oh, man. Well, yes, folks, let's go ahead and make our way to the first match back on WFWF Netwood. Season 2, folks. Season 2. I'm going to use him later. So, let's go ahead and start things off correctly. I'm going to give you the naked boy, Ric Flair. No, I should have had new gimmicks for a new season. However, I was busy working on my own shit. So, I just this is like seriously a random decision. So, Toad, good to see you. How are you today? I wish they had a rando for. I agree, Wanted. I agree. If your balls do not smack against your thigh, something is very wrong with you, even if you're a lady. So, it's the summer, folks. It's the fummin' summer. So, oh, you did Showstopper. Yeah, I love going to the Lucha Underground, man. It's one of the most fun environments ever. Let's see, do they only have... Okay, they have SummerSlam 12, SummerSlam 11. I really think they should put these in alphabetical order. SummerSlam 91. You know what? We're going to go to this SummerSlam where it's like totally early 2000s. So, if they smack against your ankle, then my only concern, Toad, is that you don't step on them. You know, just tread lightly. I said, tread lightly. I want fast momentum. Damn it. Now, why didn't I get the Marty the Moth role? You know, I don't know. I don't know. Here's the thing, folks. I sent in a demo reel to Lucha Underground. I love all 12 of you. If you could somehow get this trending amongst the 12 of you to tweet Lucha Underground telling them to hire me, if we can get all of the people who follow me, even the spam bots, to tweet Lucha Underground to hire me, I strongly believe that the majority would rule. So, hacky sack with a real hacky sack. Real, don't make your sack hacky. So, all right. let me see here. I'm just, what do you call it? Sending out. Stuff here. I'm just sending out a special text message to someone notifying them about this particular broadcast. I am so tired. MSK, good to see you. Hey, what's up, Boondocks? Alright, guys, you ready to start this? We got the naked boy, Ric Flair. Woo! Oh, yeah. Did you see that? Did you see, oh, Clamps, just before we start, earlier last week, Marilyn Mason and I had a little exchange on Twitter, and she favorited all my tweets to her. So I need to continue that, and hopefully just become her best friend in the world. Best friend with benefits. Even if it's a friend, I don't know. I'm not expecting anything anymore. So let's go ahead, folks. And let's ring the butt! So, damn these loading times. Oh, here he comes, a fan favorite. Woo, 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 woo. Here I come. I'm ready. I didn't put the belt. I didn't sign the contract. Woo, 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 woo. As seen on the front page of the subreddit for Squared Circle, the naked boy, Ric Flair. Woo! If she lives in California, then I'm more than happy to get down on it. Look at that, the Intercontinental Champion, the Wu-Tang Intercontinental Champion. Sami Zayn skanking like he means it. Bull riding shouldn't be a sport, but it is. Which has me wondering, do guys who are professional bull riders, like,
the chicks, the groupies, do they get mad if they don't last longer than 8 seconds? That's a little food for thought there. That best of three ladder series was insane, folks. It does. Ben Red, what's up? Here at the WFWF Netwood, we make sure that all our champions look awesome in the belts. That Method Zane. Look at that giant pant leg. All right. Referee Paul Reiser Jr. Ring the butt, as Dario Culo would say. There's a lockup right there. Him and the Naked Boy, Ric Flair. Naked Boy already drunk. They broke off. They forgot their spot. Now with the go behind. Getting a hold of those grandpa abs. The go behind of his own. Feeling, wow, my stomach feels great. Rick still thinking that he's touching his own stomach. Puts Sammy down with a takedown and a fist to the head. Both men back to their feet. Irish whip. No, reversal into a back elbow. And the fans are booing Sami Zayn. Knife edge chop. Could be going for an early brainbuster. Ah, just a light brainbuster on that one. Suplex. What we call here in the States. Oh, taking out the legs. They're dropping that elbow and across the lower back of Sami Zayn, who comes up with the forearm. Pushing the Naked Boy Ric Flair off of him. Hard whip into the corner, that hammer throw. Right into the back of Ric Flair, the Naked Boy, the current Samoan champion. Oh, a dirty, sweaty black sock to the face. Sammy now puts him off. Nope, Flair catches him in a belly-to-belly against those ropes. I know, I'm kind of surprised that Flair remembers to wear socks every time. I think it just looks sleazier as he scrapes those threads across the forehead and now puts him to the lower back of Sami Zayn, the Wu-Tang Continental Champion, and now trying to work the shoulder, making sure Sammy does not have strength to lift him up for that brain buster. But he trips out the floor from underneath Naked Boy, who gets the shot to the midsection. Knife edge chop, block, kick to the midsection by Ric Flair. Comes in. Whip. Ooh, damn, a swiping elbow across the mush of Sami Zayn. Who catches it? A Hurricane Rana. Hurricane Rana. Going down the Naked Boy. He goes in. Northern Lights suplex. Sami now putting those boots. And a standing moonsault. Beautifully executed by the Wu-Tang Continental Champion. Who now comes in with a Blue Thunder Bomb. But does not go for the pin. He's probably looking for an early victory against the Naked Boy. Cover. One, two, two count only. Hopefully Flair still has some gas left in the tank, but does not let that sort of stench hit the air. As Sammy stays on top of it. Huge whip into the corner. Misses that dropkick. Flair just brushes it off, but he does not miss that potato. Nobody potatoes me. As he gets hammer thrown into the corner and stumps the temple. Sami Zayn now centering Ric Flair, who rakes the eyes. Buys himself some time there. Referee Paul Reiser checking on Sami Zayn, making sure he's still able to compete. Ric Flair now, oh, trying to go for a brainbuster of his own. Sami reverses it, getting him into those ropes. Gets him into the corner now, turns her around. He's in. Oh, what a haymaker putting Sami in that corner. Nobody puts Sami in a corner. Flair now lifting him up. Snake eyes for sissies. Oh, there goes those stiff jabs. All right. Those naked punches. One, two. No, kick out at two. Sami still got some in him. I hit him with a flurry of punches. That's what he calls a flurry, because of his last name. Sami Zayn throwing Ric Flair over the top rope to the outside now. This is where the action really starts to pick up, I hope. Face buster on the outside. Ric Flair now trying to go for that punch. Sami rolls out of the way into safety. Who's now taking the back of the head of Ric Flair and throws him into that corner. Uh-oh. Sami setting him up. What's he going for? Spear through the guard wall. I don't think I've ever seen Sami Zayn do that before. And Ric Flair Dazed, confused, also drunk. When you put that type of dazed and confused over the drunken dazed and confused, that is a lot of spinning. Wow, Ryan spinners! As Flair goes into those stairs. Ooh, he hit his knee. He is not wearing those knee pads. And Sammy now taking out a sledgehammer. He knows. Oh, he bounces it off into a potato punch. Rolls through. Oh, and a haymaker. And another haymaker. Well, blocks that knife edge. Tries to go for the dropkick to the knee. Takes him out. Picks him up. Knee DT on the outside. There's no pad or giving. Well, there is padding there, but there's no give. On the outside, it's unforgiving, folks. To my understanding, for the last broadcast, it has been a while, Wanted Flipper. I'd still believe that... Oh, leg drop! Guillotine! I believe Regal still is the current holder of the Finley jacket, which will be defended today, my lovelies. That's right, folks. Oh, and an eye poke! And a shot to the little Zammies! Sammy now kicking and screaming. Ric Flair now could be going for that cock lock. Picks up. Oh, grabs the flowing locks of Sami Zayn, throwing him down right into the hard corner, folks. And now, oh, God, what is he going to do? Oh, here we go. Woo! W! Oh! 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 Woo! 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 He hit him with that woo. One, two, three. And this exhibition match is over. And the Ric Flair, the naked boy, the current Samoan champion. Watch this right here. I thought this was totally the peak for Sammy. I thought he could have won right there. Boom! Spearing Ric Flair through that guard wall. And then setting him up in a very awkward position. Hits him with the W. Oh, oh, oh. And the fact that Sammy adjusted himself to the center of the ring more. Woo, woo. Woo, 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 woo. Hitting him with that woo. One, two, three. Your winner, folks. The WFWF Samoan champion, the naked boy, Ric Flair. He is drunk as a skunk as usual. Woo. Where's Charlotte? No. He'll never, ever stop that. Woo, woo, woo. Oh, God. Oh, that naked boy, Ric Flair. Decepticon, baby! How are you? It sure is, Clamps. It sure is. All right, my lovelies. Let's go ahead. Let's break it down. We're doing this. We are so doing this, folks. This is going to be something. You know what? The ladder will take forever. I shit you not. So why not do... a elimination chamber. Okay. I'm going to leave this up to you, my lovelies. Do you want an elimination chamber? Or do you want... a multi-man ladder match for the Finley jacket? First one to get to 3 votes wins. So vote now and vote quick, folks. Do you want a elimination chamber, or do you want a multi-man ladder match for the Finley jacket held by Regal? Thank you, Mega Flyer. Son of a sus. One for Chamber. One for Finley in the bank. 2 for Finley in the bank. What will be the deciding... Okay, that's three. That's three, folks. We are doing a multi-man ladder match for the Finley jacket. Ladder wins. Here we go. Oh, damn. Everybody wants the ladder. All right. You got it. You got it, my lovelies. Lord Stefan Regal will be defending his Fit Finley jacket against Big Brother Willie Regal. Why not? Future Daniel Bryan. Let's see. The Lunatic Frach, General Adnan. Oh shit, Santino Marella. And you know what? I'm actually going to leave this to you also, my lovelies. I'm going to give you the wild card vote. So let me know, who would you like to see as the wild card? Here are your choices, folks. We have... For the wild card... Oh, fuck. Okay, there we go. For the wild card, we have your choices of... Choose one of these three. One of these three.
Seth Battle.
The Communist Party starter, Rusev. Or... The World's Strongest Honky Tonkman. So, the World's Strongest Honky Tonkman.
Seth Battle.
Or whoever the hell I, or whoever the hell else I said. So. That's one for Honky, one for Seth, one for Rusev, two for Seth. Two for Honky, one for Seth. That's it.
Seth Metal
is in this match. Seth Metal is going to go for the Finley jacket. Okay, my lovelies, let's go ahead and make our way to the Sus Slam fighting pit. This is a six-man ladder match for the Finley jacket. Lord Stefan Regal, Willie Regal, Future Daniel Bryan, Santino Marella, General Adnan, and of course,
Seth Metal.
Fans, who do you got for this match? Deuces! And Lord Stefan Regal. He is back, folks. Look at that beautiful jacket he is putting on the line here tonight, folks. Six men will battle for that prestigious jacket and an opportunity to make it their own. William Regal, his brother, says that even if he doesn't win, he is going to destroy everyone in this match. Stefan Regal is no lay-down Sally. Definitely stepping out of the shadows of his older brother once the Blackpool Black Fool's broken up. It has been one hell of a fighting Finley jacket champion. Deuces. And here he is, the most conniving, the most sadistic son of a bitch ever. Betrayed his own brother, cheats to win, and that's exactly what he's going to do here tonight. He'll have plenty of opportunities if people aren't busy kicking his ass. Open up that rift in the space-time continuum, folks. The current work-in-progress champion, future Daniel Bryan, hoping to replace that gnarly, chubby jacket of his right there. Look how wide he's gotten. Sir Widebottom. Is that flip over the top? General Adnan, the lunatic frog. He is definitely a wild man from the Sudan?
I don't know. I don't know the maps. I'm sorry.
But the lunatic frog, General Adnan, looking to take home a delicious Finley jacket.
Here comes a man who has totally redefined the technical division. He's still current reigning and defending WWF technical champion, Santino Marella. This would definitely be another trophy for his mantle as he power walks into combat.
Here comes Seth Metal!
The wild card of this match, folks. Will tonight be his night? Will he have a bitchin' Finley jacket to go with his gnarly fatigues? And there's the bell. Everyone lock it up. It's totally hard to call, by the way, all the way future Daniel Bryan getting the boots taken on by the lunatic frog. Santino going outside to catch a breath. William Regal with an atomic drop. Drop toe hold there by Santino.
Oh, knee to the midsection. The lunatic drop with an elbow drop. Oh, and Sir William already throwing the ladders in. Setting up in the center there, going for that victory early. He's got a hold of the briefcase, holding the Finley jacket. No. Oh, shit. He's going for a ride. Hit the hard corner. Regal now potatoing Santino. Seth Metal making sure that William is not the one to get this victory early. As all men, hammer throwing future Daniel Bryan, just picking and choosing his moments to go in. Smart move on his part, if you ask me. We go in now. Knee to the midsection by Sir Metal. And of course, the lunatic frog. Reaching into his tights, got some sort of brass knucks, giving the power of the punch to future Daniel Bryan. Ooh, it's Seth Metal dropping William, or excuse me, Steven across the knee. William dropping future Daniel across the knee. Suplex into that corner, Sir William Regal going to the outside. Lord Steven Regal in trouble. And now future Daniel Bryan trying to go for the victory. He's got the briefcase. No, Santino fighting him off. Here comes William. And a powerbomb into the corner by Seth Metal. Oh, and Sir William collapses into the corner. General Adnan now picking him back up to his feet. And Sir William, oh, a side Russian leg sweep hitting the shoulder blade on that ladder. No, future Daniel Bryan catches it. Actually, no one. I've been surprised with the six-man ladder matches, how they really don't last too long, because once everybody is occupied, one person can easily go and get their jacket. It's tag team matches that we got to worry about. Oh! And the lunatic throck spiking. Future Daniel Bryan on the outside. And a neck breaker. Oh! Regal with a dragon suplex onto Santino, dropping him on the head. Oh! And the lunatic throck goes right across the post on the outside by future Daniel Bryan. Regal now picking up the bloody hell. Oh! Dropping Santino on his head. Trying to go for that victory early. Seth Metal reaches for that briefcase, but Steven catches him. Tries to go for that forearm shiver. He dodges it. Power of the punch to Santino. Sir William. And a belly to back suplex by Seth Metal. Lunatic Throck now has that ladder. Taking out William. Daniel Bryan now has it. Ooh, swipes down Steven, but it gets caught from behind. Sir kicks with that ladder. Belly to belly overhead by Seth Metal. General Adnan walking up that ladder. I would have been impressed if he ran up it. And somehow managed to drop a knee across. And now Sir William going shoulder first into that post. And Seth Metal and Adnan fighting for position. Oh! Oh! Catching both those from side rush, side to more leg sweep. Goes in now, future Daniel Bryan. Going up, swinging neck breaker. Really wanted, I thought it was a tag match that I ended in a rage quit. Up in now, Daniel Bryan got the ladder. Oh, General Adnan dropping. Steven Regal across the knees, he's trying to run to that ladder, but Santino blocking him. Oh, it goes face first right into it. Steven picking up. And tossing Seth Metal aside. And there it is. The sand in your eyes. Oh, no, that's the, shit. It's the Dooney Deeds. The Dooney Deeds. The future Daniel Bryan now going with that triple suplex. Nice powerbomb there by Santino. And the Regal brothers are in trouble. Springboard high cross booty.
wrist click suplex by Future Daniel Bryan, now hopping to the outside. Both Seth Metal, Santino, Future Daniel Bryan, and Lord Stefan Regal. Whoa, with a 450 splash on the lower back, causing him to semi-worm. Oh, and Sir William getting back up to his feet. Lord Steven Regal suplexing Seth Metal. He swings around the lunatic trap, drops him across the ribs. Ooh, and a straight shot to the face with that ladder and Seth Metal. Santino getting worked over by Sir William in the corner, but reverses it, now putting the boots to him. Seth Metal now going to town, but gets hit in the back of the head. Oh, did you hear that thud? Future Daniel Bryan's skull. Hey, the beautiful leg lariat by William Regal. Santino now raged. German suplex folding him into the corner, Future Daniel Bryan. Oh, Steven. Steven's knocked out. And whoa! Regal high cross body to the outside. Nobody home. No water in the pool. Now Seth Metal. Awesome, Flipper. Make me a sandwich. Mm-hmm. Goes in now. Everybody trying to get that damn jacket. This is all for a jacket, folks. But it is a nifty jacket. Whoa! The ladder! Put on the outside! German suplex! Santino hitting the corner of that announce table. That's not Future Daniel Bryan. German suplexes Steven into that table. What the hell is Sir William doing? He's doing a samba. The ladder dance of victory. If he just climbs the other side to grab the briefcase, he could be the proud owner. No, the lunatic frog moves the ladder while he climbs. What the hell was Steven Regal going for? Drop kick. And there goes that ladder. Both the Regal brothers are down. The lunatic frog trying to get back to his feet. Santino waiting for Seth Metal. Oh! And now, Santino! Oh, he tried to go for the gold cashing. Future Daniel Bryan saw something. Gold cashing! Dropping Future Daniel Bryan on his head. And now, what's William doing with Seth Metal? Oh, the new Legacy Special! And Steven with a bloody hell! Santino's got the briefcase! Picks him up to play. And for one brief moment, folks, the Blackpool Black Fools were in control. Santino's pissed. He's taking apart that announce table. And a tossing suplex on the outside. Richard Daniel Bryan now getting in there. Oh! Seth Metal blocking General Adnan from receiving the bloody hell. Knife edge block. Float over slam. And now William. What? What happened to the ladder? Damn it. The float over slam. That ladder is dancing now. Goes in. Face buster onto that chair. Missing that rolling knee drop. Oh, an overhead hit by William onto. Oh, and the Dooney Deeds. The Dooney Deeds. Santino and General Adnan waiting for the Regal brothers to get up. Well, that was anticlimactic. Belly to belly. Oh, Santino's been busted open. Oh, shit. Steven Regal. No. Oh, lands on that ladder. Back first. And the fans are going apeshit for future Daniel Bryan. Oh, General Adnan says enough of that shit. And now Steven Regal trying again. Oh, lands on that ladder again. Oh, William Dix with a high cross body. And an acai moonsault nobody owned. Future Daniel Bryan knocked down both him and Santino. Back to the yeses. He said, no, fuck it. Look at that jawbreaker on a Seth metal. And now William Saito suplex. Wrist clutch, Seth metal now dropping. Santino. Did you get it right? Climbing up fast to the top. He's got the briefcase. No. Dropping across the knee. Sir William stabilizing him. And now power the punch. Kogashi on the Seth metal. And now General Adnan and Sir William are climbing to the top. Who's going to reach it? Who's going to overpower? They're looking into each other's eyes. It's very beautiful. It's very romantic. And now future Daniel Bryan succumbs to the bloody hell. And I think they're in love. Yep, they're in love. A Seth metal. Oh! With the hair bleacher. Oh, General Adnan getting wrapped up into those ropes. Hell of a neck breaker. And now future Daniel Bryan spiking General Adnan. High cross body. Everybody's down. 450 splash. Knocking William. Kneeing him in the top of the head. And now Seth metal. Regal raking the eyes. They're nowhere near the briefcase. Santino says, fuck you. Oh, Seth metal. Wrap him into those ropes. Future Daniel Bryan was going to win right there. Oh, right into the nads of General Adnan. Flipper, you missed some sick-ass spots. Regal now got Adnan. Lifts him up. Bloody hell! And now Steven. He's got the case. He's got the case. He's no. William's now climbing up to the top. He's got it. Oh, no, no, no! Powerbomb! Regal on Regal! And Seth says, stop that shit. Seth Metal setting up in the center. General Anand's like, no. And he swipes down future Daniel Bryan. Oh, the hair bleacher. Oh, right on that ladder. Steven now. Steven's going to the top. Oh, Santino kicks it out. What is happening to the ropes? Daniel's got the briefcase. No, Seth Metal stops it. Oh, Anand misses it. Goes into those ropes. Oh, if it wasn't for Santino, General Anand would have hit the back of his head on that ladder. And now Santino's nowhere near the briefcase. What is he doing? Oh, Seth Metal knocks him off the side. Anand falls, crumbles to the floor. Soul butt. Regal says, you want to do your fancy kicks here? Do them outside. And now, Santino. Duty deeds. Anand simply grabs the ankle of Santino. And now he's got the briefcase. No, William brings him down. Atomic drop breaking his butt. Wait a minute. Somebody please get William. Santino able to stop him. No. Seth Metal could easily climb the ladder. Here we go. Going up to the top. No, what is he doing? Santino. Trying to go for the briefcase. No. And now. Back body drop. Seth Metal over the top. Trying to get to that briefcase. No, in the corner. Here come those yes kicks. Steven now going to the top. He's got the case. No. Dragon suplex on the future Daniel Bryan, putting that neck to use. Double axe handle on his own brother. General Anand, he's got the case. Whoa, he's really hanging on. Kokichi! Oh, headbutt from the second rope, halfway across the ring by Santino. And now, Duty Deeds. Regal's got his brother. Bloody hell! Santino picking him up. Brain Buster facing him on those ropes. Santino climbing. He's weak. Duty Deeds. Nobody wants the yes chance. Oh shit, neck breaker! The body is not supposed to bend that way. And now a dragon suplex! Climb, Steven, climb! Picks him up, General Anand! Kogashi! Future Daniel Bryan, stunning. Sir William Regal, go for the briefcase. Oh, Seth Metal's busted open. and he throws future Daniel Bryan out of the bottom. Sir William, no! 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 Oh no! Sir William Regal is the new owner of the Finley Jacket! The hair bleacher. And right there, look, just simply throwing future Daniel Bryan to the side. His little brother had no idea. And right there, Sir William Regal, just like that, stole the jacket from his baby brother.
I told you, Sunshine. I told you that I was going to get what I wanted and I was going to destroy everyone in the ring. And that's exactly what I fucking did. I took your jacket. I took your booking.
Sir William Regal stole the Finley jacket. Look at that skin tag on his armpit. Do you see that? All right. Well, fans, definitely we are fucked. But hey, that means Regal versus Regal in the rematch clause. What kind of match will they have? I don't know. However, I am looking forward to it. Is it hot as fucking Oregon? Oh man, I always thought it was nice and cold there. Maybe I'll have to reconsider moving. I don't know. Don't quote me on that. Here we go. All right, folks, that was just the second match of the show. It is insanity. Insanity. All right, so let's go ahead. Regal versus Regal in a Regal on a Pole match. The Duchess of Regalberry. let's see here. I know. Why not? I know what we can do. We can do some Extreme Woos or Balls Count Anywhere, actually. Fans, while we were on break, some major personal tension has heated up. The LWO is on hold, on hiatus, due to leadership problems. And if you know your WF Netwood history, you would know that it is a constant pissing contest between Alberto El Patron and his second in command. I'm of course referring to Che Mas. Now, Alberto El Patron tends to believe that Che Mas has been gunning for his job since day one. Che Mas says that he has showed nothing but loyalty to the LWO. However, he feels that recently, Alberto El Patron has shown nothing but complete lack of leadership. So fans, we are going to do this tonight. It's going to be Alberto El Patron taking on Che Mas. Let's make our way. Now, fans, who do you got here in this battle of power? This pissing contest, if you will. Here comes Alberto El Patron. It looks like he's as cool as a cat, trying not to let this all get to him. LWO faithful, the Irish Cabron, Jay Moss, says that when he wins, he will take the LWO to new heights, new horizons. And that El Patron has always has an open spot to be his second in command. And there's the sound of the bell. Both men lock up. There's a wrist clutch. Into a hammer lock. Bruce Lee, voila! Goes in now. There's a lock up again. To go behind Sheamus. Slam it down, El Patron. El Patron getting to his butt. Bridging into a snapmare. Beautifully executed. There's a standoff right there. Valkyrie is missing this. Kick blocked by Sheamus. Into an elbow across the knee. Who's picking up El Patron, who reverses it into a face buster. So classic lucha right there, folks. Drops the jaw across the top of the head. Might be able to bite his lip or his cheek. Tries to go for that enziguri. Chicharron. El Chicharron. Oh my God, that needs to be something. Suplexed of the German persuasion by El Patron onto Sheamus, who blocks the shot. Tries to go for the Polish hammer. That tilt to world backbreaker. Love it when he does that. And now a belly-to-belly, the panza, the panza, to play. As El Patron goes in. Oh, and a kick to the lower back. If Sheamus was on Lucha Underground, Dario Culo would totally push him to the stars. So. And now going up. He had to find his position, but he did it with the enziguri. Bruce Lee, what up? Love that name. Kick again. Oh, and a drive-by. There's a boot to the head, making sure that no man stays in the dominant position. Of course, El Patron fighting off. Goes in. Nice wrist clutch takeover. Trying to get that key lock. It will snap the arm of Sheamus, who manages to roll through and drops his taint on the back of the head of El Patron. Picking it back up. Sizing him up. Oh, tries to go for that headbutt. Patron catches up with that kick with a kick to the midsection by Sheamus, who now goes in for the Irish Latino whip into the corner. Crashing El Patron down to the ground. Oh, there's a heel toe. As he's now setting up for the finish there. He thinks that could be it. One. No, Paul Reiser slapping Sheamus, causing him to kick out. Hopefully he's not playing any favorites here. He better not have taken a kick back. Oh, Sheamus trying to go for that corner splash, but thrown with that pop-up drop kick. Now picks up Sheamus back to his feet. Whip. Paul Reiser in the middle. Belly to belly by Sheamus. I'm sure he does flip it. Big elbow drop across the sternum by Che Moss. And another German suplex. In that corner, runs up. Forearm shiver, dazing the Irish Cabron. He takes him down to the center. Stomps away at the arm, hopefully trying to set him up for that cross arm breaker. No, both men missing their strikes. As Opatron lifts up. Oh no! Oh, the tequila sunset! Cover! One, two, three! He floored him! He floored Che Moss!
That's what you get when you try to take on Opatron, cabrón! I put you down like a perro you are. It is my destiny to become WWF Divas Champion.
What? Oh, Patron saying that he is coming for the Divas Championship. I don't know how the hell he's going to do that. Probably too much, Patron. Hey, John. Good to see you. And that is how it's done, folks. El Patron still in control of the LWO. El Patron looked Mexican in real life, so. All right, fans, I think we need to get into some Divas action. What do you think, folks? And I think we need to make it just a little more interesting. Fans, we got a Divas title defense as Tomoko Snuka, Naomichi Marufuji, Paige, Ima, Natty, and Summer Zane are going to go at it, folks, for the WFWF Bad Blood Women's Championship. Let's make our way. To start things off, Tomoko taking on Ima, already flooring her. Really, John? Tamango now, trying to go for that drop kick. Into a side Samoan leg sweep. Funny thing you mentioned that, Clamps. I went to the Pinball Hall of Fame yesterday in Vegas. And there was a thing in my head here that I'm like, man, shooting balls. I miss doing those broadcasts where I just talk to people and play video pinball. Ima now with an overhead egg crack. Goes in. Tries to go for a huracanrana, but Tabanco power bombs her. Says enough of that flippy shit. Ima trying to go for it again. Tabanco swipes her away. Goes in. Belly to belly. The next competitor is in. It is Paige. Interesting, John. Kick to the lower lips as Ima hits Tamanko. Paige trying to go for that enziguri. Ooh, and a punch to the ear as Paige and Ima get thrown into the corner. That hammer throw putting those Dr. Martens boots to the head of Ima. But Tamanko says, enough of this shit. I come to kill. I won't feed. Ima taking the champion to the center of the ring. What is she going to go for? Snap souple. Pops up. The Gordita crunch. And now climbing up with that lesbian elbow. Or headbutt. Tomonko's like, enough of that shit in my house. No, I didn't. And here comes Summer Zane, former multi-time Bad Blood Women's Champion. Hoping to capture it again. Roster across the knee, Tamanko. Oh, with a bad back slam. Leg sweep by Ima onto Summer Zane. We could be waiting for the next competitor to come in. We got two more to go. We got Naomichi and Natty. And now Tamanko. Oh! Pin a driver. Cover. One, two, three. Good night, Paige. Tamanko claiming her first victim. And here comes Natty with her big old tatty. Tamanko now kick to the ovaries on the Summer Zane. And now go for the shots again. Summer blocks it off. Goes in with the Irish whip reversal. Natty putting her in the corner. Flips her around. Slams her in there again. Cover. One. Kick out at one. Natty now working those unpadded knees of Summer. And here comes the final competitor, Naomichi Marufuji, another multi-time Divas champion. John Bash, good to see ya. There's a flip over. Neck breaker. Naomichi now with a face crusher on to Natty. Tamanko's like, you don't do that, Tamanko. Do that to you, brother. Throws her in the corner.
Tamanko trying to go for a drop kick, but not really working in her favor. The shove up. Emma Kavrana.
which is basically just a Hui Kun Rana, but she put her name into it. Tamanko now with a rolling cradle. One, two, three, no! Naomichi almost out early. And Natty with a back cracker onto Summer Zayn. A Clamp's favorite. DDT spiking Naomichi. Ima now. Oh, trying to go for a some sort of dilly-dally. And Natty catches her. Those are over the tops onto that steel frame, that grill. Take over crucifix, pin cover. One. No, kick out at one. Tamanko with a super kick onto Naomichi. These two have fought over who has the best super kick. Snap suplex, cover. One. No, kick out at one. She waited too long to cover her. I'm sure she would have earlier. Naomichi would have been out. And a super kick on the Summer Zayn. Cover. One. Two. Three. Summer Zayn is out. Clamps is happy. I know, Clamps. I'm so, like, happy for my boys at TMDK. They deserve a contract. They're fucking one of the best tag teams ever. I love my boys, Mikey and Shane. And a tornado DDT. Come on, go down, whipped into the corner. Natalya. With that reverse DDT onto Ima. Tamanko trying to capitalize on Naomichi. Cover. One, two, three. Naomichi is out. Tamanko stealing that victory. Powerbomb by Natty onto Ima. Ima is still in this. She started this match. Discus Lariat. Cover. One, two, three, Ima is out. It's now down to Natty and Tamanko. Oh, Natty with that lariato. Cover. One, two, no! Tamanko kicks out. That would have been definitely a shocker right there if Natty got her with that lariato. Side slam. I'm putting the boots to right, stay on top of it. Do not give her time. There you go. Gave her too much time. That spike DDT. And a boot to the lower back. Ducks under. Big clothesline. And now slapping her head. I don't know what that means. Tamanko now going to the outside. Could be going for a springboard, perhaps? Or just a grapple in general? What the hell is she doing? Oh, Natty shouldn't have went for that move. Back elbow, and another one. Drop kick and a beauty. Cover, one, two, kick at it, two. Love Amazons, John, me too. Slamming her down now. Just duck under, nope, goes in for that cradle, or the bridging pin, one, two, three, no! Tamanko kicks out. She now tries to capitalize on that. Whoa, throw face first into that cage. Tries to go for it. Tamanko catches her, drives her head right into that stiff, solid crease in the cage. One, no. Samoan drop. That's definitely gonna knock her out. One, two, three. Good night. Natty is out. She is out. Got to get tough. Go, Joe. Got to get tough. Go, Joe. When you got to stand tall. You're... No, I'm not doing that. And there she is, folks, still your Divas Bad Blood champion, Tomoko Snuka. Yeah, you know there's going to be a Cena Owens 3PS. That's how they're booking now. They're booking consistent match after match after match after match. They're getting lazy with their bookings. They need to start, like, now that they only have 2 weeks in between pay-per-views, they really need to start booking better. And booking matches that nobody's seen. That's why the Japan card is more interesting than anything that they booked in a while. I mean, shit, why not just book like that for now? Alright, folks, let's go ahead and make our way. I'm trying to think here. We actually kind of covered a lot of people today. So, alright. Yeah, Lucha Underground, the booking for that is actually a lot more exciting. Because anybody can come in saying, I want a shot at it today. I tell you what, I give you your unique opportunity. And all this other stuff. So, I mean, I don't know, man. I just don't know. Alright, folks, I'm going to do one more match. And then I actually have to head out for my meeting. But, I'm trying to think. We got that coffee. Yeah, Balor Owens is gonna rock. Like, that's gonna rock the house, especially in Japan. That's gonna be fantastic. So, yeah, the medallion, unique opportunity kind of thing, and the trios belt, they're different. You know, it's a great time to be a wrestling fan, especially for stuff like that. So, all right, folks, we're going to go ahead and move on to our main event of the stream, folks. This is our first stream back. I'd like to thank you guys so much for joining me here. This is going to be a Balls Count Anywhere. As Kofi Kingston is going to take on... Where is he? Dean Moxley, John Ambrose. Dude, if the real rock and roller shows up in Japan, I will shit myself. And I will tweet about it, so. Alright. Clamps, what do you say all the time, my brother? What do you say?
I am not certain, but I'm a pirate.
It's really true though, Clamps. This is like one of the best times to be a wrestling fan. So many alternatives out there. WWE is not the only option. You know.
I need some shame, want the shame, you want the blank.
The cannon fire erupts here in the arena as Kofi Kingston, the cruiser for a bruiserweight champion. Yes, that I'm done, yeah! There is Dean Moxley, John Ambrose, stole one of the Cruiser for a Bruiserweight Championships. Hopefully, folks, we get us a very insane match with this man event. Dean Moxley, John Ambrose versus Kofi Kingston. Ring the butt. There's that belly to back takedown. Able to go behind. And now Kofi returning the favor, but goes into a side headlock. Wednesday is crazy. I will admit, though, folks, I have not seen a single episode of Ring of Honor. Though I heard that last week's was insane. So hopefully I can find Destination America. A floating neck breaker there by Kofi. Spike DDT. And there's that elbow drop. Oh, you can find the full shows on YouTube. It's that stupid floating neck breaker again. Dropping the knee. The main cause of TNA's downfall was booking all those fucking over-the-hill workers. That is what's wrong with them. They had such a great thing going with newer, younger talent. And then even when they brought in the Bucks, they could have easily gone into a better and more exciting direction. Hell, on one of their pay-per-views, they had, Zema Ion. They had Jack Evans. They had Low Key. They had fucking all these great workers in one match for a contract. And everybody was chanting, sign them all. And they didn't. They had all this great younger new talent that nobody had seen. And what do? They book fucking older wrestlers. That's stupid. So that was, in my opinion, was the true downfall of TNA. And then Dixie came in. Oh, shit! Dirty Deeds! Spike and Kofi! Cover! One! No! A kick out at one! Awesome, Clamps. And another DDT. Damn! Dean Moxley, John Ambrose is full of DDTs today. One, two, three, that's it. He just straight up gave Kofi brain damage. One, not enough. So after the 1500th head drop, there we go. And the Lunatic Frog is watching on the monitors in the back, saying he's coming after the Lunatic Fridge. The Lunatic Fridge, Dean Moxley, John Ambrose. So that'll definitely be a feud to watch. There's your winner, folks. Dean Moxley, John Ambrose. All right, guys. Thank you so much for joining us here on this comeback special.
A 68 comeback special.
Or 69 comeback special.
I'm kidding. All right, fans, the Patreon link is down there. Donate if you would like. Share this channel. Put it with your friends. Just continue to support WFWF. I will be back. I don't know when, but I will for sure be streaming again. Thank you guys so much. Oh, I will, Clamps. Don't worry. Thank you guys. I love you so much. Follow me at Naughty Bobby on Twitter. Follow the YouTube channel. Follow this. Until then, folks, I will see you back sometime in the near future. I love you all. This is Dino Winwood saying OU 818.